The obscenity is when the motorcycle is shown, depicted, represented as a woman. Which was that ad? Where the woman's body was taking the shape of the motorcycle. She was sleeping like this on the motorcycle. So riding the motorcycle was sold to me as riding a woman. That is obscenity. Did you see it? You didn't even notice it. So you're not going to complain about it. You cannot divest yourself of facts in society. So the idea of what I'm trying to tell you is, when you discuss certification, the complexity of certification is precisely this. That when we try to certify, we try to say, ये देख सकता है लेकिन ये नहीं देख सकता, पर ये देख सकता है और इस पर कोई असर नहीं होगा, ये बताने वाला कौन होगा? So I'm going to say that this will be obscene if it is shown to a teenager. What am I trying to say? I'm certifying that this film cannot be seen by a teenager. It has to be seen by anybody who is more than a teenager. So what am I saying? There is a comment, I'm making a comment about the teenager. What is that comment? The implications. So for instance, an ad is going on and मेरे बच्चे के मैं आंखें बंद कर देता हूँ. What am I saying? कि जिस तरह मैं इसको देख सकता हूँ और इसका एक analysis कर सकता, एक frame बना सकता हूँ, इतनी समझ इसमें नहीं है. Now is that an assumption? How many times have you found your parents making a call on obscenity where you didn't find anything about it? On what basis did your parents make that call? Did you ever question them? मेरी आँखें क्या बंद करो, problem तुम्हारे दिमाग में? You couldn't have said that. और फिर finally तुम उस आग में से थोड़ा सा करके देख ही रहे थे ना? So this whole question of obscenity or what you were talking about, that there is a gatekeeping inside the organization and there is a gatekeeping outside the organization. Outside the organization, we have created what we call certification process. So we don't have censorship anymore. We have certification. Okay? Yeah, I can tell you, very interesting. I think it was during Mamata Banerjee's election last year. An MLA, I think, from Bengal, she actually did an item song as part of her campaign. Item song as part of her campaign. She did an item song, and in that item song, she did everything that any Bollywood woman does. She was the MP or MLA or whatever, and she said, vote for me. Of course, she lost, but the point is that she could have succeeded. You know, you remember that woman who, I forget her name now, I shouldn't actually have forgotten, that woman who contested with Obama, what are that? Single mother football. Exactly. So if that kind of a woman comes into parliament, just imagine that, you know, the Lok Sabha elections are going to happen. You're going to have somebody like Sarah Palin coming and saying, vote for me. What do you think would be your reaction? She's wearing a nice low cut suit. She's showing off her legs and, you know, whatever. And then she's up there and saying, vote for me. Would you call that obscene? She's talking to adult voters. Okay? So, would you call that obscene or wouldn't you call that obscene?
So, the film, that was not released in India.
Yeah. So, when we are talking about this, what we are actually locating, the place we are locating is that, can the audience understand the implications of this? So, when government or state steps in and says, "Arey, this is what I am doing. Exactly what you did to your child. Aankh band kar di usne." So when I don't show you this film and I say, no. So what I am doing is I am covering your eyes. I am saying you don't look at this film. What is the assumption? That Indians, you will not understand. Aur kuch bewakoofi karoge. So do you like it being told ki तुम लोग बच्चे हो, तुम लोग समझते नहीं हो फिल्म क्या है? बट यू अपेरेंटली लाइक इट, बिकॉज व्हेन आई डोंट सेंसर इट यू मेक अ नॉइज़. You just censor it. So are we arguing that Indians are so bird-brained that they can't understand fiction from reality, they can't understand good from bad, they don't understand what is nice, what is aesthetically good? Is that what we are arguing? Because that is what society, the Indian society appears to be arguing. We should have censorship. Because when you say we should have censorship, so who will censor? The state. Why, you don't feel responsible enough? You can't handle it yourself? Something is wrong, no? So it is like saying we need more policemen. But why don't you as society reduce the criminals within you? Policemen rakhe kya fayda? The policeman is a demonstration, live demonstration that you are producing lots of criminals. That you are not willing to accept. But you will all go on to the street and vote for more policemen. What kind of ridiculous society you have got? So would you want gatekeeping or wouldn't you want gatekeeping? If you want gatekeeping, what kind of gatekeeping do you want? So the job of the critique is to reduce the gatekeeping to a point where gatekeeping becomes an essentially informative function, certification, not censorship. If I don't show you, how will you ever know what is the difference between obscene and not obscene? So I'm going to teach you, sex education. And then I'm going to ask you, children, how are birds born? God knows. And then by implication, I'm going to tell you, that's how you were born. Now you're going to wonder. You're going to look at the pigeons and you're going to wonder, that's how I was born. Then you're going to ask uncomfortable questions. You will say, Mom, where was the egg laid? Because that's what I saw the pigeon doing. And you can't understand it. Have you seen the look of absolute fantastic embarrassment on adults when they see the dogs and bitches screwing on the street? But how did you come into being, my dear? The same way. Problem kya hai tera? Ab wo kutta hai, tu insaan hai. Matlab, I'm assuming ki koi fark hota hai. But agar koi fark nahi hai, to what's your problem? So when we are discussing gatekeeping within mass media, what we are actually trying to discuss is, who will perform the gatekeeping function? Are you going to relegate the gatekeeping function to the state? Or are you going to take that gatekeeping function in your own hands? The job of the critique will be to take that gatekeeping function within the hands of the creators and the audience and try to keep the state away. Because you don't want the state to interpret for you. You understand what I'm saying? So that's what... So if it is banned, what did people do?
Some people said, you can't do this, but they can't do much about it.
Of course they can, put it on YouTube. But they didn't have the commitment. The commitment is very limited. Why did you pick up the Nirbhaya case? That's it. Simple sensation. So don't give me this argument that Nirbhaya case was picked up because it was doing some great national duty. So when your own ground is very shaky and somebody takes it away from you, you don't make a noise. Simply because your own fundamentals are very shaky. Okay. So if supposing somebody makes a film on Nirbhaya case, kya dikhayega wo film mein jo ab tak nahi dikhaya hua? Wohi dikhayega. What is the movement which he is going to catch? He is going to catch that half an hour in the bus. Usko 3 ghante chalayega. Aur kya kar sakta? He's not going to do a bandit queen. So if you've got somebody like that caliber who is going to handle this case with understanding, figuring it out. Because it is very easy to blame the rapist. But the rapist is as much part of your society as the raped. And if you don't deal with the rapist, and if your solution is hanging, the rapist will keep coming because your society is producing them. So this is like saying ban the prostitutes and the ladies bars, but first take care of the customer, no? वो कस्टमर तो तेरा ही बाप है, तेरा ही बेटा होगा, तेरा ही भाई होगा कोई, या बाहर से इम्पोर्ट हो रहे कस्टमर, अब नहीं है वो, तो जब तक वो देखने जा रहे हैं तब तक वो नाच रही, तुम उधर कुछ नहीं कर रहे हो, उसको बैन कर रहे हो, वो घर में नचवाएगा साला। सो इफ इट गोज अंडरग्राउंड इट विल बिकम इवन मोर डेंजरस। हाउ मच डज अ डांस गर्ल कॉस्ट? अगर एक रात को मुझे उसको बुलाना है घर पे, कितने पैसे लेंगे लगता तुमको? कितने पैसे लगते? अबे 100-150 में आ जाएगी लड़की, भेजना है। कहाँ रहती है औरतें? तुमको पता होना चाहिए कहाँ रहती, जाके मिलो ना उनसे, तब समझ में आएगा कि किस तरह वो अपने लड़कों को, बच्चों को, छोटे छोटे बच्चों को अपने यू नो बेड से बांध के रखती है ताकि वो बाहर नहीं जाए, क्योंकि उनका सारा धंधा शाम को शुरू होता है जब बच्चे खेलने बाहर जाते हैं। अगर ये दोनों बाहर चले गए, 99% इनफैक्ट 100% ऑफ देम डोंट हैव अ हस्बैंड, आइदर इज रन अवे और इज डेड और इज स्क्रूइंग अराउंड विद सम अदर वुमन, देयर इज सम प्रॉब्लम विद इट वेयर देयर इज नो मैन एंड दे आर ऑल हैविंग चिल्ड्रन, सो दे टाई देयर चिल्ड्रन टू बेड्स, दे लॉक देम इनसाइड द हाउस, खिड़कियों पे बड़े बड़े गज लगा देता कि वो भाग नहीं जाए, क्योंकि उसका धंधा 5:30-6 बजे शुरू होता है और वो धंधा करीब सवेरे 4-5 बजे बंद होता है। सो उसके खाने की थाली सब कुछ रखा हुआ होता है, तू खा ले जब भूख लगेगी, और टीवी ऑन करके देखता रहे। नॉट टॉक अबाउट एजुकेशन, डू यू नो हाउ मेनी आर देयर? 17,000 है मुंबई में, उन सब के कम से कम 2 बच्चे, तो 34,000 लोग तो ऐसे ही भर गए, और उसके बगैर कस्टमर वो कर रहा है क्या? कस्टमर पे तो तुम्हारा कोई सोल्यूशन ही नहीं है, सो उसको बंद करवा के क्या फायदा? वो साला कस्टमर कहेगा ठीक है तू वहां नहीं नाच रही, घर पे आना, आज पार्टी करेंगे। यू थिंक दैट्स नॉट हैपनिंग? ऑल दोज रेस्टोरेंट्स वंस यू गो फ्रॉम कालीना टुवर्ड्स सांता क्रूज, वो सारे होटल्स आपको नजर आते हैं दोनों तरफ, वो होटल्स क्या है, कैसे चलते हैं, कौन रहता होगा वहां पे, कभी देखा है अंदर जाके? That is what, when we are discussing these things, as critics we have to see that whenever this is being represented in the media, what is the frame in which it is being represented? So, oh, this is being banned, but why were you showing it? Was that showing an innocent act? Was it an aesthetic act? Or was it simply an act of provocation? If it is an act of provocation, then it has been provoked and he is responding it in that way. Now you can't complain, मैं तुमको झापड़ मार रहा हूँ ताकि तुम गुस्सा हो जाओ, तुम गुस्सा होगा तो मैं कह रहा हूँ गुस्सा मत हो, ऐसे कैसे होगा? द होल आइडिया झापड़ मारने का आइडिया वो कि तुम गुस्सा हो जाओ, आई कैन नॉट से नहीं मैं मारता रहूँगा लेकिन तुम गुस्सा नहीं होगे, ऐसा नहीं होगा। और फिर जब वो गुस्सा होगा तो वो जो भी उसको करना वो करेगा। यू आर एज अ क्रिटिक कॉट इन दिस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रेम वेर यू विल ऑलवेज बी डिस्कसिंग दैट हाउ डू यू डील विद दिस होल थिंग। Okay, so whether it is the paintings of M.F. Hussain or whether it is the films of that Nair or Geeta Mehta, whatever you are doing will always be put in this whole circuit of gatekeeping. And our argument in criticism is that the gatekeeper should be members of the audience, members of the creative media, not the state. So as far as possible, you avoid, keep the state out. Okay. Because when you get the state inside, by definition, the state has to be more mediocre. It cannot be the finest of the finest. Because the finest of the finest will be maverick. They will be breaking the rules, which is why they are out there. If those who are following the rules are those guys, you know, those 4,500 log jo roz savere sham ko ek ek train mein bhar bhar ke North Mumbai se South Mumbai jaate hain, fir sham ko South Mumbai se North Mumbai jaate hain. There are all those simple characters, simple ideas of obscenity, simple ideas of what is good, what is bad. They are not going to inquire, question, discuss, debate, discourse. They are going to do that. Right? So always, when as a critique, when you are talking about these issues, you will be trying to put the spotlight, trying to find out, wait a minute, who is going to be the gatekeeper? What is the gatekeeping function like? Why is this particular thing being produced? And then you have to put that disclaimer. I am trying to provoke you. Are you provoked? Yes? Okay. But you cannot say, put provocative material and then say, but why are you getting angry? What do you mean you're getting angry? You're making me angry. And you're saying, don't get angry. Aisa nahi ho. Okay? So you have to ask, if it was stopped, what was the content like? What is so unique about the Nirbhaya case? No, lots of rapes happen publicly. In fact, in India, if you rape, you do rape it publicly. Especially if it is considered concerning something about caste, religion, then you rape it publicly. You think the women of Godhra were raped in hidden quarters or what? They raped in bloody public. Because rape is clearly a power struggle. So it's nothing about public. So why is it so big? There's a reason why it became so big. Huh? Carnal. Rape is carnal by definition. Why is it so big? Are you aware of how many rapes happen in India every day?
It was hyped by media.
Why?
Similar cases have happened, but this one
was. Why was this one hyped? Now look at it in terms. This is exactly what you have to do as critics. Why this one?
Because of the conditions.
What were the conditions?
Like it was a normal, it wasn't, it was early night and it was a normal time when people travel, and during that time inside a bus.
Okay.
And it was a school bus and police was supposed to be patrolling there.
See, now look at the symbols, look at the words you are using. That is exactly how you critique. What you are talking about is an abnormal event happening in what you think is normal. So what is normal? Where is the normal here? Which according to you happened abnormally? School bus is normal. You do find school buses. You do find that school buses double up as passenger buses. That's a corruption in your society. Acceptable to all of you. Why? Did you protest against it ever? No. You are aware that these drivers and the conductors and all that are completely illegal because they are supposed to be running a school bus, not a passenger bus. You are aware that you are the kind of people who are paying them. Why? Because your system is not giving you enough transport. This is normal, no? Now that normalcy has been corrupted. Meaning what? That two people got in by the same normal conditions and one of them was raped and thrown out. And she died. Why are you worried now? Because it is your normalcy that is threatened. Otherwise, वहाँ पे thousands of tribals are being raped all the day. You never protested. You protested because she was one amongst you. If she was some Kamwali bhai, do you think that would have made headlines? It wouldn't have. Because she is not part of you. She was a physiotherapist. Middle class. One among you. That is why you made such a noise. Otherwise, rapes of women is hardly relevant. You're not bothered about it. So, which means that you as society will only react when you as society identify with the crime. Otherwise, you don't really care for the crime. It is not as if you are concerned about women. Because gender abuse is not something restricted to any caste or any religion or any class. It is across the board. We abuse our women, full stop. Anybody who disagrees? Nobody. We know we abuse our women. We know we are a gendered society. Just go and ask mom. She'll tell you. Was she ever asked? Is a female's will in sexual matters ever expressed in Indian society? Does a female have a choice? Ask. Go and ask your mom. Did dad ever ask you whether you want to sleep with me or no? Never even had a choice. Do you think you people will have a choice? How many women here sitting think that they have a choice? I don't want to have sex tonight. And then this gentleman of a guy will listen to you. You don't have a choice. If that is the situation, what are you talking about? So why did such a big noise about Nirbhaya? Simply because now you are personally, you see a personal threat. Because you are the people who are doing this. Going by contract buses, which are not meant to carry passengers, which are supposed to be carrying children, you have never complained about them. Now you are worried, ye mere saath bhi ho sakta. So far you are quiet. Wo dalit hai yaar. Are wo tribal hai. Wo backward hai. Wo udhar hota rahe. Rural area mein hota hai. Ab tumhari Delhi mein hota hai. Now Draupadi is being raped in the parliament. Ab sari Draupadiyan badi chinta mein aa gayi. Agar ek princess is raped in parliament, तो जो मामूली औरत है उसका क्या होता होगा उस राज्य में? उसका तो कोई अस्तित्व ही नहीं होगा ना. इमेजिन सोनिया गांधी ड्रैग्ड ऑल इनटू द पार्लियामेंट एंड रेप. मतलब तुम लोग का क्या होगा रास्ते पे? मैं क्या कर रहा हूँ रास्ते पे? यू थिंक मैं संत आदमी हूँ, राम की तरह घूम रहा हूँ? पॉसिबल ही नहीं है. द डेटीरियोरेशन इन सोसाइटी वुड बी फार मोर सीरियस बिकॉज द डेटीरियोरेशन इज बींग सीन इन पार्लियामेंट. दैट इज द हाइएस्ट बॉडी वेर वन फील्स एब्सोल्युटली प्रोटेक्टेड. Because I represent huge numbers of people and I feel protected there, then the protection will be coming down. But if that is where the abuse is happening, to idhar to koi badi baat hoi nahi. That is why you are worried. Because she is one of us. The tribal woman, the Dalit woman, she is not part of us. They are not middle class. Oh, educated nahi hai. Oh, padhe likhe nahi hote. So rapist kaun hai? अरे वो ऐसे ही लोग ना, काम बंद में ही होता, अनएम्प्लॉयड लोग होते हैं. नो नो सॉरी, ऐसा कुछ नहीं होता. अदरवाइज वी वुडंट हैव मैरिटल रेप एज अ सेक्शन इन आवर लॉ. सो एज अ क्रिटिक यू आर एक्सपेक्टेड टू बी वेरी क्लोजली कनेक्टेड टू द सोशल मोड बिकॉज ऑब्सिनिटी लाइज देयर. दैट इज अ लोकेशन. क्राइम इज इन दैट सोशल मोड. हाउ मच इज योर सोसाइटी इवॉल्व्ड? हाउ केयरफुली हैज इट इवॉल्व्ड? What are the various dimensions in which your society is learning to look at your world? Because the younger and younger people, their definitions are different, their values are different, and because your values are different, you will constantly have to keep looking at your world over and over again. It is changing very fast. Okay? So what you are actually trying to do as a critique is, this is what the mass media is showing you. This is the content. It has gone through gatekeeping processes. So it has been published, it has come out. One assumes there are gatekeeping processes. And it is now come out into the open. Which means now it is going to be consumed by everybody. And everybody means everybody. Okay. Now tell me how many of your newspapers are obscene. How many of your newspapers you think are obscene? Which stimulate desire, which is out of context. So you and I may understand that are jairat hai, but the newspaper is falling where? It is not falling in your private space as adults. It is falling in the family. And in the family you have a kid that big and an old guy. They have different ways of perceiving the world, which are different. Their ability to perceive is different. And the newspaper is falling here. So, that is where your argument is. That if this child is going to watch always a car associated with a woman, what is going to be in his head? He doesn't understand all this. That is why it becomes obscene. Okay? But if it is shown to you and me that there is a car and there is a woman, now we understand the male is the buyer and the female body is one of the most simplest way of getting this gaze to fall on the product. So you put the female there, the gaze transfers and the gaze then falls onto the car, and then the buyer knows that okay, this car I am buying, the woman is just as a front. But for this small child who is just beginning into puberty, his body is beginning to explode, and he can't understand what is happening. So it is quite possible that this child will believe that a guy will look at me only if I am with a car. And you do have young people who believe that. It is not as if their parents have told them anything. So why do you think you have these all muscle fellows with motorcycles, brum brum brum? Because they have in their bloody head. that वो motorcycle की धड़धड़ाती हुई आवाज, why is it that the bullet is the largest selling motorcycle in contemporary India? It's a bloody noisy thing, hopeless to manage, उसका average भी गंदा है, फिर भी ये मर्दानी bullet क्यों ले रहे हैं? Because in their mind they have conceptualized a woman who will come running at them, because ये धड़धड़ाता हुआ मर्द आ रहा है, धड़धड़ So you know, and it is not just the male, even the female feels wow. वाह का डमले सर चला के देखिए कभी कितना वजनी है पता है गाड़ी वो और सब उल्टा है यहाँ पे गियर है तो उसको उधर उल्टे साइड में गियर है इधर ब्रेक है उसको उल्टे साइड में ब्रेक है मतलब बुलेट चलाएगा तो बाकी कोई गाड़ी चलाएगा नहीं बिकॉज जहाँ पर ब्रेक रमन है वहाँ पे गियर दबाएगा और एक्सीडेंट करवाएगा सो वंस यू अंडरस्टैंड ऑल दिस यू विल क्या फालतू की बट दैट इज द मॉडल इन विच इट इज वर्किंग एंड हाउ डिड इट अपियर बिकॉज मोटरसाइकिल इज सपोज टू बी मैनली supposed to be a signifier of male and the woman is sitting behind and hugging him and you know whatever so I mean if you have gone to an ordinary orthopedic you know that that seat is one of the stupidest seat you can ever have but why is that seat there कारण ते पोरीला पण आवडतं असं छान त्याला बिलगून पावसामध्ये मी चालली आहे हे माझं स्वप्न आहे आणि दुपट्टा असा फडफडतोय आणि मग मी त्या हेल्मेटमधून मी असा वगैरे करते अरे पण बिंडो क्या तुझ्या स्पायनल कॉर्डचं काय होतंय कळतं का तुला नाही ना समज मला उसको और वो मर्द भी बड़ा आनंद में उसको भी लगता है देखा म्हणजे काय माझं पौरी सगळं असं वाहतंय सो वो भी चला रहा है सो इट डजंट अकर टू देम की नेमकं काय करतोय बाबा तू सो यू विल फाइंड दिस इज समथिंग सो वेन पीपल इन मुंबई बाय अ जागुआर वाय दे बाइंग इट क्योंकि जागुआर चलाएगा कहाँ ओके यहाँ मरीन ड्राइव उसने छोड़ा उसके 15 किलोमीटर की एवरेज स्पीड है और अगर कहीं सबर्ब में घुस गया तो सामने रिक्शा पीछे रिक्शा सो क्या मतलब क्या फायदा अभी जब है जागुआर बड़ा आवाज वो कर रहा ब्रुम 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 वो फायदा क्या लल्लू उससे अच्छा रिक्शा में जल्दी पहुंचेगा बट वो जागुआर में बैठा हुआ फंस गया जागुआर सो रिगार्डलेस ऑफ व्हाट यू डू हियर व्हाट यू आर एक्चुअली ट्राइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड इज दैट व्हेन मास मीडिया प्रोड्यूसेस समथिंग पुट्स इट इनटू the masses it is talking about ideas it is talking about perceptions it is talking about values and all those values perceptions etc you are as a critic will have to translate you'll have to go behind it and you will have to say and discuss ki why is this happening okay for instance just to again make a kind of final for you to understand that you will find that popular song lyrics in the United States are very hardcore expressions of their popular culture unke yahan jo bhi burai achhai ho rahi hogi uska direct reflection you will get it in popular culture especially in their popular music so american popular music reflects its realities jo bhi america mein achha bura ho raha hai wo seedha seedha wahan pe reflect karta whereas indian popular music produces the exact opposite of whatever is the indian reality now this is a cultural thing which means that if you want to understand american popular world if you listen to their music you will understand how it is working if you want to do the same thing in india you'll have to listen to the popular music and then imagine the exact opposite because that is how we have dealt with our production our entire media as far as you know producing electronic activity is concerned or cinema or television deals in escapism सो जो आपकी दुनिया में जो भी वास्तव होगा उस वास्तव का बिल्कुल उल्टा प्रतिबिंब हम उसको दिखाते हैं कैसा सब बिल्कुल आनंद ही आनंद है कैसा सारा भक्ति में डूबा हुआ है वगैरह वगैरह ऐसा सब दिखाएंगे इसका मतलब यह है कि यहाँ पर कुछ उल्टा है ओके विच इज वाई यू विल फाइंड द मोमेंट यू गो टूवर्ड्स रियलिटी योर सिनेमाज वैल्यू गोज डाउन इट इज बिकॉज वी आर एज इंडियंस वी हैव गॉट एन ओवरवेलमिंग सेंस ऑफ रियलिटी okay as indians we have got an overwhelming sense your reality is absolutely next to you how many of you sitting here have got a private space to yourself in your house wahan par agar baap bhi aayega to darwaza khadkhada ke aayega permission lene ke baad aayega how many of you got a private space that is your reality and you need that private space at least to masturbate you need it You don't even have that. which is a simple biological function. But you don't even have that space. Wahan pe, the private space is guarded like anything. It is defined. वो बाप भी आएगा तो दरवाजा लग टक टका करके आएगा. और ये कब से होता है? जब वो 7-8 साल का रहता है तब से वो इस प्राइवेट स्पेस में बढ़ता है. ऑब्वियसली इज दैट चाइल्ड्स एबिलिटी टू मेक चॉइसेस फॉर हिमसेल्फ और हरसेल्फ इज मच बिगर देन योर चॉइस. बट व्हाट इज द लिमिटेशन ऑफ दैट चाइल्ड? दैट चाइल्ड कैन नॉट थिंक फॉर एनीबडी एल्स बट हिमसेल्फ. व्हाट इज युअर लिमिटेशन? यू आर थिंकिंग ओनली फॉर अदर्स, यू आर अनेबल टू थिंक फॉर युअरसेल्फ. तुला काय पाहिजे? मेरे को एक्चुअली क्या है ना कि जर्नलिज्म करते हुए फिल्म से जाता हुआ थिएटर से इंटरेस्ट है और मुझे संगीत करता हुआ मुझे नहीं कैसा है कि जर्नलिज्म बाप को पसंद है, फिल्में माँ को पसंद है, चाचा ये कहता है, हमको पोसने वाला हमारा मामा है, ऐसा करके वो जोड़ के ऐसा कुछ एक बनाता है. सो ऑल योर रियलिटीज आर फ्रेगमेंटेड इंटू यू नो मामा को ये पसंद है, चाचा को ये पसंद है, बाप को ये पसंद है, मेरे दादा ने मरते मरते कहा था पोता ऐसा होना चाहिए, ये सब कुछ लेके तुम अपनी आइडेंटिटी बनाओ. फाइन, दैट इज ओके. बट तुमको क्या चाहिए? तुला काय पाहिजे? काय बाबा काय? मला काय विचारच नाही केला या, मतलब वो कॉन्सेप्चुअली नहीं है, उसको एग्जैक्टली पता है उसको क्या चाहिए. बट अगर अरे बाबा तू ये करेगा तेरा बाप मर जाएगा, दैट्स हिज प्रॉब्लम. अरे बाबा अरे पण बाप आहे तुझा, मैं घर छोड़ के चला जाऊंगा, असं काहीतरी तू विचार कर. सो व्हेरी फोकस्ड ऑन व्हाट दे वॉन्ट. बट व्हेन इट कम्स टू व्हाट यू एग्जिस्ट इन सम काइंड ऑफ अ लार्जर रियालिटी, उनका लार्जर रियालिटी से कोई लेना देना नहीं होता, उनको बड़ी तकलीफ होती है कनेक्ट करने में. योर प्रॉब्लम इज यू आर कॉन्स्टेंटली कनेक्टेड टू अ लार्जर रियालिटी, फैमिली, कम्युनिटी, कुंबा, देश, समाज. सगळे भारतीय समाजसेवक असतात बिकॉज त्यांचं बेसिक साईजच 5-10 लोक असतात इन द फॅमिली. इन द इन्फ्लुएन्सेस इन युअर फॅमिली देअर मस्ट बी ॲटलीस्ट 3 or 4, राईट? अपार्ट फ्रॉम द 2 पेरेंट्स देअर मस्ट बी ॲटलीस्ट 2 अदर्स. सो देअर वुड बी सम पार्ट ऑफ द फॅमिली, सम पार्ट ऑफ द नेबर, सम पार्ट ऑफ द बिल्डिंग, असं कोण एक तुम्हाला लाईफ को इन्फ्लुएन्स करतात अँड यू ॲक्सेप्ट ॲडमिट दॅट इन्फ्लुएन्स. ओके, ऑल दिस इज शोन इन युअर मीडिया. यू एज अ क्रिटिक विल हॅव टू लर्न टू अंडरस्टँड की तुम्हारी दुनिया है कैसी. ओके, सो ट्राय अँड गेट यू नो ट्राय अँड गेट कनेक्टेड टू इंडियन रियालिटीज. यू विल सी दम प्लेड आउट इन युअर सिनेमा, यू विल सी दम प्लेड आउट इन युअर टेलिव्हिजन सिरियल्स, यू विल सी दम प्लेड आउट इन युअर न्यूज पेपर्स. दोज आर इंडियन रियालिटीज. दे एक निकालते जाओगे तो कुछ दिखेगा नहीं. ट्राय टू सी इट एज अ कॉम्पोजिट पिक्चर. अँड वन ऑफ द इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग्स अबाउट कंट्रीज लाईक इंडिया इज दॅट ऐसा लगता बडा केओटिक है. आप सबके घरों में एकाध शादी ब्याह हुआ होगा, कहीं पे हुआ है ना? ऐसा कोई है जिसके घर में एक भी ब्याह नहीं हुआ, जिसने कोई ब्याह देखा ही नहीं है ना? एकाध ब्याह तो देखा होगा. सो अगर देखा होगा यू विल फाइंड कि ऐसा लगता बड़ा क्योटिक है. हो भी होगा कि नहीं है, बट अल्टीमेटली हो जाता है किसी तरह. धड़ते बढ़ते वो कहीं से पुजारी आ जाता है, कहीं से वो आ जाता है, कहीं से ये आ जाता है, ऐसा करते 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 हो जाता है. इफ यू आर रियली अ स्मॉल यू नो इफ यू आर अ स्मॉल चाइल्ड लुकिंग एट दिस यू विल फाइंड नहीं रे मुश्किल दिख रहा है, बहुत मुश्किल नहीं होने वाला है. बिकॉज इतना है ना, नहीं नहीं लड़की वाले तो यार लड़के वाले ऐसा ये वो करते 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 फाइन. अरे हो गई शादी, बड़ा मजा आया, इट वॉज फन. बट दैट इज एग्जैक्टली हाउ दिस कंट्री वर्क्स. इनफैक्ट वी पाकिस्तान, बांग्लादेश, श्रीलंका, वी ऑल वर्क इन दिस पिक्यूलियर फैशन वेयर 99% चांसेस आर दैट समथिंग विल नॉट वर्क, बट इट वर्क्स. हाउ डज इट हैपन? पता नहीं, ऑल काइंड ऑफ फैक्टर्स कम टुगेदर एंड समथिंग हैपन्स. So that is exactly what you will have to learn to live with and understand ki tumhari duniya kaisi hai, and these are the small small factors which you will have to bring to your table. Once you get a hang of it, okay, then it is fine. So you people are going to play a very crucial critical role in helping that masses out there who is busy living his own life to understand and interpret what is the media doing. Okay, which is why it is so important for you to know Indian sociology, Indian politics, Indian economics, Indian markets, as well as the media. What is representation? What is semiotics? How does the language of media work? How does the language of cinema operate? So ye dono cheeze aapko samajhna hai tabhi jaake aap ek function kar sakte ho, which is called the function of bridge building. Okay, because one of your first functions as a critique is to bridge a build a bridge. Okay, there'll be songs, there'll be drama, there'll be theater. You have to actually move across and say ye samajhne ke liye ye karo, aise dekho tab nazar aayega. Okay, So we're going to look at the chores of a critique, and the first chore that we looked at was building this bridge. Apart from building a bridge, the next kind level of function that you do is to suggest new directions. There is a very peculiar aspect of the Indian audience and the Indian media, which is one that we are huge in number. Okay, huge. And how huge? So the government of Maharashtra had found a very peculiar problem when we were broadening our roads. One very interesting problem was on the Mumbai-Ahmedabad road. Okay, Mumbai-Ahmedabad highway. It was a single lane highway. So idhar se ek car jayegi, wahan se ek car aayegi. They wanted to make it into a 6-lane highway. One of the problems was ki wahan pe toilets nahi the. Why were the accidents very frequent? Because truck drivers, car drivers, because journey is long, they used to just park somewhere and go into the woods. So there are toilets honi chahiye. So they wanted a proposal ki bhai kitne toilets honi chahiye. So ek aadmi sochta ki bhai toilets kitne honi chahiye, bhai ek aadh toilet ho jisme 10-12 toilets ho. This is how you think. Jab zarurat nikali gayi to pata chala ki 700 toilets ki zarurat hai. So hamari jo choti si aavashyakta hoti wo itni badi hoti. Okay, if you look at purely in terms of population, जो घाटकोपर का n वार्ड जो है ना, वो n वार्ड का पूरा पॉपुलेशन अगर जोड़ दिया जाए 5-5.5 lakh का, वो पूरा पॉपुलेशन ऑस्ट्रेलिया नाम के देश में रहता है. Now if you are going to compare Australian economy with my economy, that's bloody stupid. क्योंकि मेरा एक म्युनिसिपल वार्ड 5 lakh का है, तेरा पूरा देश 5 lakh का है बे. ले जा मेरे यहाँ से 10-12 lakh, फिर देखते तुम्हारी इकोनॉमी क्या होगी. इफ़ यू आर गोइंग टू लुक एट इट इन दिस सेंस, यू विल हैव ऑलवेज बी फेस्ड विद द प्रॉब्लम बिकॉज आवर नंबर्स आर सो ह्यूज. सो इट इज़ वेरी नाइस फॉर पीपल टू से वहाँ पे बड़ा अच्छा होता है, लोग रास्ता क्रॉस करते हैं. मेरे एक फुटपाथ पे जितने आदमी होते हैं उतने तेरे पूरे देश में नहीं होते. सो आई हैव टू थिंक इन डिफरेंट वेज. द सेम थिंग हैपन्स विद मीडिया, दैट द न्यू ऑडियंस विच इज़ कमिंग. अभी भी ऐसे लोग हैं जो सहगल को सुनते हैं और बड़ी तादाद में. अभी भी ऐसे लोग हैं जो मुकेश को सुन रहे हैं, फिर एक लोग तबका है वो मोहम्मद रफ़ी को सुन रहा है, फिर एक है जो किशोर कुमार को सुन रहा है, फिर एक ऐसा करते करते शान, और फिर शान तो अभी ऑलरेडी बुढ़ा हो गया, उसके नीचे अब और लोग आ रहे हैं. सो ये मेरा रेंज है और मुझे इन सबको खुश रखना है. सो व्हेन यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट न्यू डायरेक्शंस, यू विल फाइंड दैट असिमिलेटिंग, acculturizing and constantly constructing new images is one of the functions of the critique. Have you ever seen that the range of music that you are listening to, range, is far bigger than the range of music that your parents listen to? Understood? Can you imagine what will be the range of music that your children will listen to? Because you will obviously be outdated from your children. तुम्हारी रेंज दिख रही है तुमको, तुम्हारे माँ बाप की तुलना में उनकी रेंज कितनी और तुम्हारी रेंज कितनी. नो इमेजिन कि उनकी रेंज क्या हो. कैन यू नाउ प्रोड्यूस एनी काइंड ऑफ म्यूजिक फॉर दैट जनरेशन? अभी जो बच्चा 5वीं में 6वीं में है ना, उसके लिए म्यूजिक बनाना है, बना सकोगे? कैन यू मेक इट? Can you imagine क्या संगीत, somebody with a sound record is, no? Yeah. बनो ले ऐसा क्या? Have you made any music like this? What kind of music do you make? I can't hear you. Huh? No, do you produce music? Or do you mix it? Okay. So what is your audience profile? Yeah, but youth starts where? 14, 13, 12? 9, 10, 12. So your target audience is 12-year-olds? So what is the difference when you say I'm going to make music for 12-year-olds and I'm going to make music for 20-year-olds? Is there a difference?
As the age increases, there is a soft music. And if the child is young,
No, so what is the difference? In musical terms, what is the difference? Okay. So the 12-year-olds are listening to something louder than the older people? So older is how old? 20, 30, 40?
It's not 20, it's 35.
So your range is from 35 to 14?
Yeah.
They listen to the same kind of music?
It's not like that. But they will not prefer this kind of music. They will not prefer much.
Okay. Okay. So these are the kind of talks you need to generate with people who are in the industry. Okay. Who are the people, for instance, who are going to, do you know how many classes of Hindustani classical are there in Mumbai? Har suburb mein 3-4-5 honge na? Yeah? So घर में करते होंगे या बोर्ड लगा के क्लासरूम स्कूल में करते होंगे करेक्ट एक इसमें कितने होंगे स्टूडेंट्स ओके सो इफ यू लुक एट द गंधर्व महाविद्यालय विच इज द सेंट्रल बॉडी विच टीचेस दिस काइंड ऑफ म्यूजिक उनके पास रजिस्टर्ड टीचर 3,500 हैं और 3,500 के पास अगर आप कहेंगे कि एवरेज 10 लोग जा रहे हैं मतलब 35,000 लोग सॉफ्ट म्यूजिक सुन रहे हैं और जो बच्चे हैं तो अगर ये बच्चे सॉफ्ट म्यूजिक सुन रहे हैं तो इनके बाप भी सॉफ्ट ही होंगे इनकी माँ भी सॉफ्ट होगी अब इसमें से समझ लो कि 50% ऐसे लोग हैं जिनके माँ बाप चाहते हैं इसीलिए सॉफ्ट म्यूजिक सुन रहे हैं और चुप चुप कर वो कोई हार्ड म्यूजिक सुन रहे हैं ऑल दीज आर योर रियलिटीज सो वेन यू आर प्रोड्यूसिंग योर म्यूजिक वेन यू आर डीलिंग विथ योर म्यूजिक यू विल हैव टू बी कॉन्स्टेंटली अवेयर ऑफ वॉट आर योर ऑडियंस टेस्ट लाइक एंड वेन यू आर अवेयर ऑफ दीज टेस्ट You are going to give input to people like him or people around you. What are the changes that you will produce? What are the new directions that are emerging? Okay. The new directions could be in the sense of rhythm, which may change. The sense of bass, which may change. The sense of treble. The sense of texture. So musical textures may change. Right. For instance, a very interesting thing that is happening in India, which is quite, well, there are those purists who regret it, who think this is very bad. But there are other people who think, well, this is normal. Which is that all the corruption in the song is being kept there. They are not removing the corruptions. It is kept inside the text. Do you think this is bad or do you think this is good? So if there is a hum, there is a buzz, there is a sound, It will be kept there. They will not remove it. They are not cleaning it up. Do you think that is good or bad? To answer that question, you have to understand how has the listening culture changed in your world? Has the listening of music changed? How? What is the change? That is the content, just listening. Sunne ka jo tarika hai, has that changed?
It's more distracting as a distraction.
Oh, that's the purpose. Just singing, just listening. Has the way of listening changed? What were your, how were your parents listening to anything? Radio. Which meant ki wo aisa phaila hua, aur idhar udhar sab awaazein, aur wo radio, remember Murphy radio, Sony radio, wo sab chalta tha. After that you have come to headphones and earphones. So it is getting into a more private space. It is getting a more upfront. Okay. So as your headphone quality improves, your desire for better music is going to improve. Because now you can discern smaller sounds, more clarity. Correct? Now if there is more clarity involved, how many of you will be able to listen to an alap or a khayal? Simply because in clarity, you want more music. Alap aur khayal mein ek gaane wala jugara. That's it. So you are going to look at more and more music with a lot of instrumentation, with a lot of fine tuning, with lots of various sounds, because now you can hear them. Correct? Right? No? Huh? Yes, because lyrics, ठीक है कह दिया, I mean गुलाब का फूल था, okay, brilliant. तो अभी वो पूछेगा कि करना क्या इसका? Forget the lyrics. The sound quality has to improve. The kind of vocals you're going to use are going to improve. Especially the kind of way you use the instruments will improve or change. As the listening quality changes, okay, what is the difference between the kind of music you're listening yourself and the music on television shows? Have you heard the music on television shows? What is the difference? Is there a difference? What is the difference? Something very interesting is happening on television shows, which is a very peculiar fact which takes into account this particular event. One important aspect is all serials seem to have an opening song. Okay? So why do you think you have a song?
So that you, like, you know, many times it happens, it's a tendency where you remember that serial.
To recognize the serial.
Yes.
Okay? So the song, the sound is getting you to the serial, not the visual. It is not the story even. It is the song that says, अरे वो लगी है, switch करो. Okay? उसके बाद उस serial में किस तरह की आवाजें होती हैं? Yeah, so what, remember, what do they signify? That sound signifies something. Yes, it signifies what? It signifies situations. Okay? So, 10 situation, you know, वो सुनाई देके तुम बता सकते हो, अभी कुछ बुरा हो रहा होगा, अभी कुछ अच्छा हो रहा होगा. आवाज देखकर ही बता पा रहे हो. सो द साउंड हैज बिकम अ डोमिनेंट फैक्टर विद इन द सीरियल्स टेक्सचर, विद इन द सीरियल्स कंस्ट्रक्ट. व्हाई इज इट लाइक दिस? सिंपली बिकॉज यू आर बिगिनिंग टू हियर मोर. यू आर ऑलरेडी बिगिनिंग टू हियर समथिंग दैट इज वेरी लाउड. ओके? बट यू आर नॉट हियरिंग लिरिक्स. नाउ व्हेन यू आर नॉट हियरिंग लिरिक्स एंड आई वॉन्ट टू गेट यू टू द टेलीविजन सेट एंड माई सीरियल्स आर अबाउट फैमिली ड्रामास, lyrics repeated over and over and over and over again. Okay, if you look at that entire thing, bade acche lagte hain. The entire selling point of the serial is the song. It brings memories. The serial has nothing to do with bade acche lagte hain, the original. Technically, in terms of, you know, story, it has nothing to do with it. But you are drawn to it simply because of that peculiar song. And the more the song culture is there, wherever the song culture is very strong, in Maharashtra, Bengal, Tamil Nadu, where the song culture is very strong, you will find that the serials have a very strong song base. Where the song culture is not that strong, you don't find it that strong. Okay? So if you look at Malayalam serials, you don't have song base. Because in Malayalam cinema, it is visual. Very strong on visual. Clear? Are you getting the picture now? So for you to suggest any kind of new direction, you will have to be very tuned into how is your world evolving? How is your media world evolving? Okay? So do you think news should be presented to you in a song and dance fashion? No?
Until it's not
meaning? Entertainment news should be presented in a song and dance fashion. But if it is hardcore news, no?
Because if it's hardcore news, we only feel connected. As in, it's a business.
No, I'll just have an opening song before I tell you what the news is. Remember, why I ask you this question is that we have got a culture in our folk media, okay, where song foregrounds an event. ओके ये तो वही बात हुई सॉन्ग और फिर क्या बात हुई दिस इज आवर फोक मीडिया कल्चर यू हैव सीन फोक मीडिया नो नाट्य संगीत वगैरह बघितलं की नाही बघितलं ना शुअर नो एनीबडी इज नॉट फेमिलियर विथ इन नाट्य संगीत क्या होता है एक प्ले बताओ नाट्य संगीत का नाट्य प्ले नाट्य संगीत नाही Yeah, that's an old culture in Tamil. Which one? They use compositions of who? Bharatiyar and Tyagaraja.
Ah, Tyagaraja, yes, I see.
So, काय मराठी माणूस कुठे आहे? The tragedy of the Marathi माणूस is hardly Marathi. But he'll vote for Manse, that's the bloody problem. Yeah. So, all of these cultures are essentially foregrounding music or song to a situation. And the situation is real. The situation is real. So, for instance, if you go to Kirtan, which is a national phenomenon, you know, across the country you have Kirtans. In Kirtan form, you've got a very interesting design, which is that you first say a verse. Okay, you first say a verse and then connect it to an existing situation. So, what are the challenges before this country and how shall we resolve it? Kabir ne kaha tha. Now you sing it. You sing a text. After this, you say these are the problems before the country and this is how we'll solve it. Okay, this foregrounding is a normal process. A lot of Hindi news channels use it. Okay, it was famously used in a Marathi program called Tickle the Political. Anybody saw it? Okay, so no, you remember, no? Tickle the Political? Yeah. So, it began in the classical format of the Vaganatya. The Vaganatya is a format where you have got two characters, Krishna and Pendya. Pendya is his, lame friend. So, Krishna comes and Pendya is the humor character. So Pendya says, Kaya Krishna, aajkal kaya jam jacket bigad galdo yaar. So Krishna says, Ma, Mukhya Mantri kon hai? That was the time when Manohar Joshi and Gopinath Munde were the Mukhya Mantri. They used to wear jackets. So Krishna comes wearing a jacket and Pendya says, Kaya aajkal jacket bigad pehen ke bahut shine mar raha. So Krishna says, Are Mukhya Mantri na, jacket galava lagta. So now this is a foregrounding. The entire play begins with this foregrounding and then the news comes, actual news. A lot of this was used by very interesting channels. One was which used a puppet. Remember? So all of this are new modes and new directions which we are taking because we want to address the audience. And when we address the audience, we have to deal in the manner of the audience. And that is one of the reasons why that classical American phenomena called the debate, the political televised debate, will not work in India. Why will not work in India? Why will it not work in India? You have got the classical American election, the presidential debate televised, and it's a big drama. And it's taken very seriously. And presidents could win on the basis of that debate. Okay? This cannot work in India.
We are having multiple parties
actually. So, theek hai na, jo 4-5 log khade hai, sabko bula lo election mein. Khada kar do stage ke upar. But it's not working. Why is it not working?
I guess emotions are...
चुनाव आपके होते हैं या अगर प्रधानमंत्री के तो हमारे यहाँ पे सांसद चुने जाते हैं
नहीं तो ठीक है ना, दो सांसदों को भिड़ाओ. You don't trust the narrative of the politician. If I'm a politician, I'm announcing myself to be a politician for the Lok Sabha election, and I come here and say that, you know, one of my concerns is poverty in India. I'm serious. Okay, I think I'm going to, you know, one of our problems is communal violence, and I have to ensure that I have to resolve it. You don't believe, the moment I say I'm a politician, you don't believe me. Because our political narratives are not trusted. We trust our judgment, not what the politician says. And that is one of the reasons why judging, you know, meaning trying to estimate an Indian elector's or a voter's mindset is difficult. Because ye aadmi jo sochta hai, wo kabhi batata nahi. Wo seedha ballot box mein dikha deta hai, jo bhi karna hai. पूरा हिसाब 5 साल का कर देता एक ही झटके में. एंड इट डजंट, कभी अंदेशा भी नहीं होता कि ये इस तरह सोच रहे थे. यू कांट मेक आउट. दैट इज वन ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ प्रेडिक्टिंग अवर इलेक्शंस. इट इज बिकॉज द इंडियन, बिकॉज ऑफ दिस पिक्यूलियर स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंटली लुकिंग आउटवर्डली, इज सो ट्यून्ड. ऐसा लग रहा है कि ये ध्यान नहीं दे रहा है, सुन नहीं रहा है, देख नहीं रहा है. वो सही जगह पर पूछता रहता है, तू किसको कर रहा है वोट, तू किसको कर रहा है, तू किसको कर रहा है, तू किसको, सब झूमता रहता हो. और वहां जाकर थर्ड एक्ट वोट. एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ विच इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर द पॉलिटिशियन टू रियली गिव आउट अ नैरेटिव. इन आवर इलेक्शन कैंपेन्स द पॉलिटिशियन इज मोर लाइक एन एंटरटेनर, मोर लाइक एन एंटरटेनर. एंड विच इज व्हाई यू विल फाइंड दैट दोज पीपल हु आर एंटरटेनर्स खूब गर्दी होती, जीत के नहीं आता. जिंक तो कौन तरी भलता. ओके, वी हैव एवरी पॉलिटिशियन हैज रिग्रेटेड दिस. नेहरू रिग्रेटेड इट, अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी रिग्रेटेड इट, बाल ठाकरे रिग्रेटेड इट, एंड राज ठाकरे इज ऑल्सो रिग्रेटिंग इट. दैट वेन दे कम 5 लाख जे लोक ऐकायला आले, टाळ्यांचा गडगडाट, हा मग शेवटी बाळासाहेब म्हणतात वोटरनी माझ्या पाठीत खंजीर खुपसला. वोटर हुशार आहे, तो त्याचं डोकं वापरतो. तुम एंटरटेनमेंट प्रोग्राम करना, मैं एंटरटेनमेंट देखने आया, क्या प्रॉब्लम है, क्या ताली भी बजेगा. अच्छा, जोक वॉज गुड, बट आई डोंट वोट फॉर जोक्स, आई वोट फॉर समथिंग एल्स. दैट इज वॉट हैपन्स टू राज ठाकरे, फैंटास्टिक एंटरटेनर. सो यू विल फाइंड यो गर्दी, ताड़ा बीड़ा पण पड़ता, वोट नहीं हो रहा है. वो वोट अपने हिसाब से ही सोच के देता, वो इसी को देगा और वो उसी को देगा. ही इज नॉट वोटिंग फॉर सम दिस स्ट्रेंज आइडिया. ओके, एंड दैट इज समथिंग विच रियली स्केयर्स द इंडियन पॉलिटिशियन. The Indian politician is really worried and scared and anxious. Nobody can really judge that Indian voter. तो काय करेल हे सांगता येत नाही. शरद पवार ने अपनी लड़की को खड़ा किया, 25% मत गायब, जस्ट डिसअपीयर. नाउ ही इज वरीड, अभी अजीत दादा को खड़ा करूँ या सुप्रिया को खड़ा करूँ या फिर से खुद ही खड़ा हो जाऊँ. इज डजंट नो. सो ही गोज अँड आस्क, काय चुकलं, काय झालं, काय नाही, काय चुकलं नाही, मग काय, पण म्हणजे वाय, वाय इज माय वोट गोईंग, काय नाही बोलतोय नाही. वो वोटिंग मही करता जो भी करणार, ही डझंट टॉक. ॲज अ रिझल्ट ऑफ विच ब्रिंगिंग दिस डिबेट आउट ऑन टेलिव्हिजन विल सिम्पली बिकम अ नॅशनल एंटरटेनमेंट प्रोग्राम. बियॉन्ड दॅट इट विल नॉट वर्क. अँड द रिझन वाय दिस हॅपन्स इज बिकॉज वी आर स्टील स्टीप्ड इन टू अवर फोक मीडिया. And in folk media, you know ki kirtankaracha kirtan aiktana parmeshwar prapti hot nahi, ratra changli jate. That's it. Okay, that difference is understood in a very rustic kind of manner. Okay, so when you're trying to suggest changes and new directions, you will have to be attuned to your world, which is your emerging new media world. There is a generation of people emerging who are now completely disconnected from the old media. And as a result of which, your solutions will have to be different for those people. Okay? The third is proposing system cognizant change. The first part was suggesting new directions to the existing system. But the third one is proposing system cognizant change. Meaning that will we have to change the system of producing content? Will we have to change the system of delivering content? Do you think that one of the problems with cinema is our system of delivering the cinema to the people? Do you think that is a problem? Is there a problem? Do you know what is the system by which we deliver our cinema to the people? How is it delivered? Who does it? See, is the director, the story writer, is he involved in this process of distributing the cinema to the viewer?
I think he should be
involved. No, should not. Don't talk odd. What is?
He's not involved.
I think he's involved.
He's at the back. No, it's the producer.
Is it the producer? Or is it the distributor? So the distributor is at the front of this selling process. The producer, director, story writer, etc. The story writer, I think, is gone away. I mean, he is not even considered. So you have got only three elements: producer, director, and star. These three will determine that selling process. Poster pe kya hoga? Gaane kaun se jayenge? Kitne poster lagenge? Kitne bada poster lagenge? Kitni baar lagenge? Kitne pehle lagenge? कब तक लगेंगे? All of these decision, ये तीन and the distributor takes the final call. So if the distributor wants to destroy you, ये तीन कितना भी जोर लगा ले, फिल्म आगे नहीं जा रही. And how many distributors are there? Who have the capacity to ensure that your film reaches the audience across the country? So it is an oligopolistic situation. When you say oligopoly, you study the media economics. So it is oligopolistic. In an oligopoly, if these characters come together, they can actually make or break your market. And why will they touch any cinema which is not part of the mainstream? So when you talk about system cognizant changes, what you are actually saying is trying to identify what is the process by which anything is coming into being. Okay, for instance, Yash Chopra tried something which is even something which Sanjay Leela Bhansali has tried or Ram Gopal Verma has tried, which is to produce an organization which will support the key players in making cinema. Today what is happening is, if you want to make a film, you gather together the people you require till the film is made. Once the film is made and shown, these people disappear. Because then they become parts of other teams, making some other film. And then again, when you want to make a film, again you have to gather all these people together. So people like these, what they are saying is, let us have a single system where hum log writers rakhenge, directors rakhenge, cinematographers rakhenge. So we will keep some key staff where we will constantly be able to produce the film. Is it feasible? Can you produce cinema like this? Does it work profitably? These are questions of system. Studio systems. Those break down, they became individual, now again they are trying this. One of the key elements in this is insurance. Can you insure the success or failure of a film? How much can you insure? Surely it should be easier now. Considering what? That you can now break the film into its components. The songs will sell, the film may not. Or the television version may sell, but the theater version may not. Or the mobile version may sell, the television version may not. So because you can break cinema into its components, it might work. Maybe it's fantastic to watch on mobile phones or tabs than watching it in a theater. So maybe its songs are very great, but the film is bogus. So now you can break it into components and tap different markets. Okay? All this thinking is called system cognizant change. Okay? You are essentially trying to make the system see what kind of change can be brought about in itself so that a new structure can emerge. A new structure of cinema making, a new structure of reading. One of our interesting problems is, where does a writer who has got a good story, where does he read his film? Sunani to padegi na kisi ko. Anybody has gone to a film reading? Where did you go? Where was it? So it's a house.
It's a house, yeah. So the director, me, and the art director, yeah, and my editor, and one of actors.
You know, so it is not a location where, yeah, cinema has to be expressed, cinema has to be acted out, it has to be worked on. So the reading is done across restaurants, coffee tables,
tapri.
That's where they discuss story. We don't have reading sessions. Okay. Getting the reading session is a problem, right? So we will be having a small workshop. We'll be doing this in September. I'm hoping that by that time, some of you will have some idea of stories and you will be writing something, because unless you have a story, you can't really do much. The whole workshop will be about putting together a film script. Okay. So I'm hoping that some of you would want to, I mean, aajkal ye ho raha hai ki media schoolon ki wajah se sabhi ko director banna. कोई लिखना नहीं चाहता, कोई गाने नहीं लिखना चाहता, कोई संगीत नहीं करना चाहता, सिनेमाटोग्राफी नहीं करना चाहता, कॉस्ट्यूम वगैरह, सभी को डायरेक्टर बनना है. सो आई एम होपिंग कि कुछ ऐसे होंगे दो चार जिनको लिखने का शौक होगा. सो अगर लिखने का जिसको शौक होगा, जिसको कहानी कहने में मज़ा आता है, अपनी कहानी कहने में, फॉर देम वी विल हैव अ स्मॉल वर्कशॉप विच विल बी अबाउट 10 or 15 days, विच विल बी पुटिंग इट टुगेदर विद दिस गाय वर्क्स इन हॉलीवुड. ही कम्स हियर एवरी ईयर. आई डोंट पे हिम मच बिकॉज आई कांट. But he helps you put together a script, which will be a film script, a final bound film script. Okay, that's depending on how you are able to perform. So we'll work on that later. But the whole idea here is that to work on all these various things, we will have to be able to see what kind of system exists. Okay, we have a serious problem with recording studios. We don't have enough recording studios, and the locations of these recording studios are bad. Not because the recording studio people, unke akal nahi hai, but things are so bad. I mean, for instance, one of the very interesting recording studios is Ajivasan. Ajivasan, familiar? Suresh Vadkar ki apni recording studio is in Juhu. There is a problem in that recording studio. The recording studio is under a school. Okay? So, upar school chal raha hota, niche recording studio. He's done everything. The problem is that, I think at 7 o'clock in the morning, then I think at 12 o'clock in the afternoon, then 1:30 again, school khulta hai aur shuru hota hai. To jo footfall hai, wo sound flow ke aapki recording mein aa jata hai. So you have to be very careful. He do batayega aapko ki aapko ye kitna accurate chahiye. So if you say nahi chalega utna, to theek hai, wo awaaz aati hai. Beech mein tab 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 ye awaaz aati hai. Because people are thousands of student children, they're running down tab 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 karke. So wo jo awaaz hai, it actually flows into your recording. But if you want absolutely accurate, then you have to book that studio from 8 o'clock to 11 and finish whatever you want to do up to that, because by at that time wo bacche upar jane lagte hain aur agli batch niche aane lagti hai. Okay, all of these are real things. There is a studio in Malad which is next to the highway. Because it is next to the highway, savere 7:30 se 9:30 baje tak agar aap kar rahe hain to wahan pe ek ajeeb sa buzz aata hai. Inside the studio, it is on the ground floor, and inside the recording you will get that buzz, because the traffic is going at such a horrible speed. Wo sara that sound will there, halka awaaz aati wahan pe, and then you have to are tam tam yaar awaaz aa rahi, thak ja. So you have to wait. These are very peculiar problems of Mumbai. Okay, so when you are thinking system cognizant change, this is what you are thinking. Clear? Okay, think in terms of people, think in terms of infrastructure, think in terms of finance. All of that is system cognizant change. One of the important aspects of becoming a critique is serving as a proxy or a watchdog. Because one very important function of the media is to create an autonomous society. You know what is autonomous? Autonomous? Familiar with the word? Anybody who doesn't understand autonomous? Autonomous? Autonomous is the ability to act with absolute freedom. Swayattata. So, what you are doing as a critic is devolving the power which exists in the artist to the people. So, you as a proxy or a watchdog, your function is to devolve this power which is in the artist. The artist knows what is happening. Okay, you as a critic will take this out and send it to the people so that the people begin to understand you. What is the danger if people begin to understand your work? Duplicates. Okay, that is as a creative person, I have a danger.
Then
you
start questioning
you. Okay. As a creative, my creativity, there is a problem. Firstly, it becomes demystified. The danger in creativity is, you will say, "Ye pehli baar bataya tha." So I have to beat my own creativity. Once you know how I did it, you don't want to see the same thing. You want to see something different. So which means, if I have shown you a film, and if this critic has completely demystified it for the audience, next time when I show something, you will want to see something different. Because the critic has already passed on the power. Because the critic has passed on the power, you as audience have become more powerful in relation to me. First time when I walked in with this canvas and this painting, I was powerful. You did not know anything. So I sit down and start painting. After I finish the painting, you still feel powerless. Okay? Now the critic walks in and he tells you, next time when I come in, I can't do the same painting. Because you know more about everything, my style, my choices, everything. Now you will say, "Haan, abhi kuch alag bata." So if I don't do that alag thing, you will say, "Arey, toh yar pehli wala hi bata. Agli baar show khatam, koi nahi aa raha." So you are the proxy, you are the watchdog to ensure that the creative person is challenged to produce something more creative. Clear? And this is what a good creative person who is really caring about his creativity will want a critic to do just that. Break down whatever I am doing for the people so that I am challenged to be more creative. If I am hiding my own, mystifying my own creativity, then I am essentially afraid that I can't be more creative than what I am. So because I am afraid, I don't explain to you ye kaise kiya. Because jis din tumko samajh mein aa jayega, agli baar magic nahi hoga. Okay, you know, did you see that film Aajcha Divas Maza? I think Mahesh Manjrekar ji film.
That
okay, there's a fundamental flaw in the film, and that is a problem with all Mahesh Manjrekar's film. That if you find that fundamental flaw, then the whole film is bogus. The fundamental flaw is like this: there's a blind singer who has been invited to sing. The singer knows that he will be singing in the presence of the chief minister. Right? There's a queue of people. The chief minister is going to meet each one of these people. The singer is in that queue. What are the chances that a blind man will sit in the corner? The chief minister is going to come like this, meet one person after another. And I'm at a position, I'm the blind man. I'm at a position here. I'm just sitting here and I'm looking there. And the chief minister is coming from there. If you've been blind, you will be even more careful, especially because you've got a chief minister. So the fundamental premise is so faulty that the entire film looks like a joke. It is enjoyable if you are willing to be convinced at a very vague point on time and earth, this is possible. If you allow that, then the film works. Okay? But if you don't allow that, then the film is a joke, because the fundamental premise on which it stands, because then the chief minister screams at this guy, he abuses him, and then he feels very guilty. And then he says, "Is aadmi ko ke liye mujhe aisa kuch karna hai jisse mera guilt kam ho." And then throughout the film, what the chief minister does is uses all his power to get him a house. That use of the power, the drama within it, all that is fantastic, but the core premise is faulty. Okay, have you seen that other film Shikshana Chahiye Go? Okay, the fundamental premise is basically bogus. That fundamental premise is expressed in a very interesting way. this man is interested in cricket, but he says, I'm not interested in mathematics. The problem is not with his interest, the problem is with the guy teaching him. Because if you're a cricket player and you are so interested in cricket, sahacha pada alas paije na. आणि सहाचं येतो म्हणजे तीन आणि नऊ आलाच पाहिजे, कारण तो तसंच आहे. आणि तीन सहा नऊ आले म्हणजे दोनचा येणार, म्हणजे पाचचा पण येणार, उरला सातचा. सो वन टेबल का काय प्रॉब्लेम आहे इसको मॅथमॅटिक्स का? और अगर ये सचमुच क्रिकेटर है तो इसकी फिजिक्स से दुश्मनी हो ही नहीं सकती, बिकॉज थ्रोइंग द बॉल इज अबाउट वेलोसिटी, स्पीड, एयर, विंड. इसकी दुश्मनी ज्योग्राफी से नहीं हो सकती, क्योंकि ऑल ज्योग्राफी इज अबाउट द पिच. So it was a problem with the teacher, not with the student. So the fundamental premise is wrong. Shikshanacha nahi, shikshan paddhatiacha manacha tula. Mo man na shikshan paddhatiacha. Shikshanacha kay mhantu murkha sarkha. So if the fundamental premise is wrong, the film is bogus. Otherwise the film is very exciting. But the core premise, that is one of Mahesh Manjrekar's problems. If the core premise is always faulty, he doesn't work on it. Okay. For instance, if you look at Amol Palekar, if you look at Amol Palekar's films, especially his later films, they appear to be cinematized drama. So it is actually a play which is happening in theater. It is just that he has put it cinematically. So the language is not cinema. The language is theater. Therefore, the shot taking, the reactions, all of them are based on theater rather than cinema. Okay, so you will be watching it, you will be like proxies and watchdogs who will try to find out what is the social mode, is this obscene, is this ethical, should this be shown, can our audience understand it. All of these questions are something which you will put together as an understanding of your world, and that is how you will guide the audience as well as the producer of this content into some kind of a synergy. Okay, is this clear? Any confusion? And the last part of it, which is your fifth job as a film critic, as a critic, and that is one of the most crucial parts, which is that even as a critic, don't forget, you are supposed to entertain. Is that clear? As a critic, you are not this extremely boring, stern kind of character who walks in and everybody shivers in their pants. Your critical understanding has to be entertaining to the audience. So the critic is not an outsider. The critic is the insider of the insider. Okay? You know, Pula Deshpande vasle? Okay. So those who have read will understand the context, but otherwise also you will understand. That is Ustad ji bulate hain ki, हमें आपके पास तबला सुनना है, हमें आपका तबला सुनना है, हमें आपका तबला सुनना है. तो उस्ताद जी बड़े परेशान हो गए, अच्छा ठीक है चल बैठ सुन ले. और उस्ताद जी शुरू करते हैं. जो समझदार होगा उसको पता है कि वाह किधर कहना है, लेकिन अगर तुमने गलत जगह पर वाह कहा तो उस्ताद जी को पता तुम बेवकूफ़ हो. फिर उस्ताद जी कहेंगे तू जा भैया तू मत सुन, क्योंकि तेरा कोई फायदा नहीं, तू समझता नहीं. सो द क्रिटिक हैज़ टू अनफोल्ड ओपन this structure. Okay, what is the ordinary audience going to do? The ordinary audience will listen to 3 minutes of A.R. Rahman and be very happy. What is critic going to do? The critic is going to find out what does A.R. Rahman listen to before he produces that 3 minutes of fantastic music. But if the critic is going to listen to 3 minutes of A.R. Rahman, then you can imagine what criticism will produce. What is the audience going to do? Audience will go and watch the cinema which is playing. It is a critic who will look at other cinema which has played and then put it into the context. Ki ye na idhar se hai. So the audience out there is not expected to listen to Ilaiyaraja and then understand A.R. Rahman. Audience is supposed to listen to A.R. Rahman. Mast gaana vatla. Beautiful. Taale vajavle. Paise dile. घर गया सो गया फैंटास्टिक. द क्रिटिक्स जॉब विल बी, अगर ए आर रहमान ये है तो उसके पीछे क्या है. सो देन योर जॉब विल बी ए आर रहमान वो क्या सुनता है जिसमें से वो 3 मिनट निकालता है. ब्रिजिंग दैट हैज टू बी एंटरटेनिंग, इट कैन नॉट बी बोरिंग. ओके, सो यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट योर फंक्शन इज टू एंटरटेन, एंड एज यू एंटरटेन यू आर सपोज टू डू दीज अदर थिंग्स विच इज टू बी एबल टू बिल्ड अ ब्रिज, टू सजेस्ट चेंजेस, changes which are new directions or changes which are within the system, a cognizant change, all of this will be part of your function. As you do it, you also have to entertain. Okay, this clear? Yeah, okay, we'll stop here and continue tomorrow.